I'm violinist Randall Goosby, and here are four black composers whose music and stories I think you should know about. So the first composer I'd like to tell you about is William Grant Still. Often known as the Dean of African-American Composers, he was a man of many firsts in the way of African-American classical musicians in general. He was the first to have one of his compositions played by a major American orchestra, the first to conduct one of his own compositions with a major American orchestra, as well as the first African-American composer to have one of his compositions broadcast nationally across the United States. Grant Still was often celebrated for his symphonic compositions, namely his first symphony, the Afro-American Symphony, but I'll play you a little bit of one of the few works of chamber music that we have from Grant Still, his suite for violin and piano. So the next composer I'd like to tell you about is also African-American, and her name is Florence Price. Up until recently, a lot of Florence Price's music was unknown. It was actually discovered in a former summer home of hers outside of Chicago in 2009. The home was set to be destroyed, and instead, they found hundreds of pages of beautiful music written by Florence Price. She was born and raised in Little Rock, Arkansas, before she ended up actually achieving enrollment at the New England Conservatory in Boston, where she was able to sort of meld her musical roots of singing spirituals with her family and singing hymns in church with more traditional sort of Eurocentric classical forms and practices at the conservatory. She's also, in addition to being known for symphonic compositions, composer of art songs, recital works, as well as some chamber music for smaller ensembles. But I'll play you one of my favorites, a sweet tune called Adoration. Next composer I'll tell you about is a European composer, not quite as recent as Grant Still or Florence Price. Joseph Boulogne, Chevalier de Saint-Georges, was a French composer born in Guadeloupe to a French plantation owner and one of his slaves, eventually moved to Paris and studied a number of things, was obviously a prolifically talented musician and violinist, was also a conductor, composer, and a champion fencer as well. He really did a little bit of everything and even commanded a legion of the Revolutionary Army in France. But Boulogne was widely celebrated for his talents and actually gained the affection of one Marie Antoinette. He's known for all sorts of compositions, duos, chamber music, symphonies, 14 violin concertos, one of which I'd like to play for you now. I don't know how he had the time or the energy to do all that he did, but he did, and in a completely different time, so it's been so lovely to see the recognition that he's been starting to regain over the past few years. So I'll play you a little bit of his G major concerto, number 9, opus 8. Last composer I'd like to tell you about is best known actually right here in the UK. Samuel Coleridge-Taylor was a graduate of the Royal College of Music and was widely celebrated not only for his prolific compositional and violinistic talents, but namely for his choral and orchestral compositions, which were widely celebrated throughout the UK, especially right after they premiered. Actually, the great Edward Elgar was the one who recommended him for a premiere at the Three Choirs Festival in Worcester. And it was so well received, actually, that it was said to have perhaps dwarfed one of Elgar's own compositions in reception. So I'll play for you a little bit of one of my favorite pieces as of late, from Coleridge-Taylor, which is his suite, Opus 3, for violin and piano. It's a very early work, and it's a collection of four small, short, very charming pieces, and this is the first movement called Pastoral. So wonderful speaking with you, and I hope you learned a little bit about just a few of the many Black composers that are only now starting to gain some of the recognition that I think they deserve. Through history, it's no secret that Black people and classical music are not exactly two things that go hand in hand, but it's for reasons that are different than what we might think. In my experience, it's simply a sort of lack of exposure, a lack of access, a lack of opportunity. Amongst Black communities, specifically in regards to classical music. Now, being slightly older than I was when I started, it's been so great to see these composers and their music start to regain some of the appreciation, or I should say gain the appreciation that they haven't really enjoyed over the past 50, 100, 200 years. In the future, do all that you can to keep an eye out for new and exciting composers, whether they're alive or not. There's always something new to learn, and there's always something new to discover. And I think that's one of the most exciting things about classical music and really about the world today. There's so much that we don't know about, and these composers and their music just offer a different story.